Itinerary of a Pilgrimage. Of course, you wouldn't start from here, since we haven't time for this, and time hasn't time, except we're here, to find pleasure in the motion it takes to leaf the sycamores, the comfortable physics between us collapsing as we pass, to see that we can't see a view periodically, so consummately here, with all the notebooks being undone, to want to feel seen, perhaps, entering into words obscured with a strip map of speed away from landscape and association, approaching topographies of picturesque features, botanical affirmations of polite tourism via charts that serve the needs of the traveller, any advances metalled, performative of experience, of acceleration, except framed within the horizons of the carriage, always progressing safely to seek contrast and brightness in filters and edits, the whole panorama a freakish wonder, but no transcendental signifier possible. Audiences, cutting the flowers of spring, sweeping the autumn leaves and dying in winter's freeze, WTAF, winter knows what is repeated is the moss on the roof of the Royal Mail Depot, the pasture rotating for car boot sales, lands of quarries and reservoirs, the grain stores, iron girders, the scrubby trees felled on the embankment, the cars on narrow lanes bonded by muck and wet, while instruments dwindle and aesthetics creak in sheds and laybys, described with precision as if they remain the unimaginable other, and the distant lights thumbed away, the volume resting down at zero and the bounds beaten out until all is reckoned fair. And what we miss is the solitude of communion, the coda stretching, those ones, those nothings, while you are outside and aching.